to fall.
Lodge will now conduct house by house search for the accused and any stolen goods. Recovered goods.
Abby! Abby, what am I gonna do? There's 10 of them out there! Oh, I knew this was a bad idea.
We got the medicine, though. Okay, okay, you go. Quickly, and make sure everyone who's sick gets the serum and takes
what?
It.
No!
Go!
What if...
Then we figure it out. Trying or dying, Chuck.
Right. Serum. Everyone. Got it.
Open the door, or it will be...
Quick! Out the back! Chuck nodded and scrambled out the back door. I could tell he wanted to ask me what I was gonna do. I didn't know yet.
What's going on?
Law Jack's father. They'll be coming in.
If you want a bad vision of the future, it's a boot stomping on a human face forever.
Shh, father!
Guy in a wheelchair and a sick old man. Not overcue.
Their voices were hollow behind their grimacing masks.
Right. Well, let's search the place anyway.
Merciful mother, what a dump. How do people even live down here?
If you're moral, you reap the rewards. If you're not prospering, it's because you've made the choice to reject society and propriety.
My father was struggling to sit up.
Apparently all these lawjacks can do is lick boots and harass old men in their beds. Must be a lot of boots.
Quiet, old man.
Nothing. Nothing in here.
Let's go!
Good riddance.
Is the medicine working, father?
Yes, I'm feeling better. Every minute.
Good. I hugged him. I need to do something very important. I'll see you afterwards. I love you.
I love you, son. Thank you for never giving up.
Never will, father. I went outside. The law jacks had wrenched the neighbor's arm behind him and were holding him down. They were all armed and their uniforms were heavily reinforced with armor. The man they held wore one of those cheap jumpsuits you get for a couple stands out of a clink. I looked around at the damage, the brutality, the injustice.
Where are the stolen goods? Where is Chuck?
I wheeled up to the leader. Officer, I have information for you.
Ah, finally, a smart one. Well, where is he? And where are those stolen goods?
Well... I paused to take a deep breath. Chuck is... He didn't commit the crime. I used his cyber kit to crack the lock on that pharmacy. I stole the medicine, and I... Well, it's gone. And you won't get any back. My name is Abimaras, and I confess fully, and will submit to servitude to repay the goods and damages. Chuck is innocent. The lawjacks looked at me, dumbfounded. After a moment, their leader shrugged. What happened next? I don't remember. There was a sudden searing pain in the side of my head. I assume he hit me with a shock club.
Alright, folks. Grab this debtor and let's clear out of this hole.
And that, Raz and Dion, is both why I am here and why I get so many visitors.
That's such a good story.
I'd be stupid if you asked me.
I didn't.
The world is mad. Old magic and new technology run amok. Used by the powerful to create empires of wealth and dominance. Resistance, while it may seem reckless and painful, is the only prudent response to such a world.
The goal of our subversion is a society which is governed not by mortals nor by gods, but only that which makes for peace. A society that does not need lawjacks to force people to love. A society which does not need to strip people of their freedom to keep them free.
the present is still splattered with blood and the future still dark, the force of resistance and the value of freedom give us new reasons for living. And if we are to fail, it is better to have stood with those who are on the side of life rather than those bent on destruction and domination.
Welcome to the Undercity.